Right, ladies and gents, I hope you can hear this. I got a little bit near the camera because it's really, really windy. last few days we've had a good dollop of snow in North Wales. Some places worse than others. I've just seen the news a while back, and after a couple of days, Cardiff in South Wales got about 2.5 feet of snow last night, apparently. The northeast of Wales isn't as bad, but there's plenty about. But the snow is actually that very powdery form. You can't even make a snowball out of it. It snowed really heavy, but a lot of the fields around here haven't even got any snow on them. They've just been stripped by the wind. I've been waiting for the snow for a while. There's a couple of projects I wanted to do. And no, my luck, it'll get nice and warm tomorrow and it'll start melting. So I'm going to dig myself a snow hole in a drift I've found. It's not a particularly large drift. It's pretty dismal, really, but I've seen better. But it's not too far away from home, so I haven't had to lug loads of gear miles, and I'll show you this drift in a minute. It's actually on the side of a country lane, but the lane's blocked at the moment. In fact, some idiot a few minutes ago just came up behind me, and I had to gesture to them not to come any further. The lane lower down is clear. Come round the bend and they confront you with a 3-foot wall of snow. So, and I know they got 4-wheel drives, these people, but the brains aren't always in 4-wheel drive mode. And to be honest with you, there's a really crap number of people who go out in the snow and they shouldn't be allowed on the road. Some of them shouldn't be allowed on the road when there's no snow. Anyway, I'm gonna spend an hour digging myself into this drift in a snow hole, in the hope that the snow isn't so powdery that it doesn't just collapse and make a mockery of what I'm trying to do. It's not the best snow. It's not the sort of wet snow you can make a good snowball with. So I don't know how it's going to be when I start digging into it. But I'll just turn this camera around. This is the snow and the drift. I'll go down here. So I'm gonna dig into this. As I say, never get any peace and quiet. There's some bloody pedestrian coming up the road now. So this is what I'm gonna dig into. That stick marks the spot. And we'll see what there is to do. If this camera's picking up what looks like snow at the moment, it's a mixture of snow and existing snow that's already on the ground, which is blowing. They forecast some more snow this afternoon, and I think it's just starting to kick in now. It's quite a bit coming down, which may add to things later. As I say, I'm just going to turn the camera around again. Where this drift is here and that stick, I came up here earlier and spotted this drift. It was building up yesterday. I came up earlier and that looks like a spot where I might want to start digging into, so I'll try that. We'll see how we get on. I've been wanting to do a couple of projects in there, some decent snow. As I say, the last decent snow we had in this part of Wales was 2012, and I've sort of prayed every winter we get a decent bit of snow. Luck's never on my side. We get a good dollop of snow this year, and it's actually quite powdery, and as I say, it's blown away all over the place. So the idea is to dig a hole into the drift, as you might do if you were stuck on a mountain or something. This is all very tame, this. I would prefer it to be a bit more wild, but beggars can't be choosers. So I'm going to dig into it, create a cavern, and once inside, drag all the gear in. And I've got my gas stove, so I'm going to have a brew up. I'm going to melt some snow, make a brew, and then a bit later I'm going to fry some chips on an open fire in a little shallow cave I'll make opposite the entrance, and I'll do that as it gets nearer to dark. And then I'll consider kipping down for a few hours. Say it's digging this way into the wind means the wind's going to blow over you. It's the wind chill that gets you if you're stuck out. And it feels about minus 6 or 7 now. I think it's only just above freezing, just below freezing, but with the wind it's a lot colder. So I say, maybe minus 6 or 7. But the temperature tonight will plummet, probably to about minus 10. So, we'll crack on. as you can see there, I've reached the original bank with the hedge on top. So what I'm going to do now is swing left and use the bank as one wall, and as I say, I'll swing left and go about maybe another 6 feet perhaps, and you can see these lumps of snow. I'll use some of them to guard up the entrance. Snow's coming down quite good now. I've got a couple of feet, 3 feet to the left there. A little bit more to do. You can't half notice the difference in temperature just getting in there. It's got to be easy. 3 or 4 times warmer than it is outside. So, I'll plod on. It'll be a tight fit. So it's not the best drift in the world. I wouldn't make it bigger if it was a bigger drift. So, I'll plod on. And maybe the next 30 minutes I'll be in there. Making progress. I'll just put this camera inside the hole. Just lower this a bit. Bloody tripod's freezing up. Put that in here like that. Flip it round. So I'll just gradually work away on this, enlarging it a little bit, and almost ready for occupation. Banked up the front now, give it a bit more shelter. There's enough room to clamp it in. Zoom in there. So I'm just going to nip inside and see what it's like. Well, it's a bit of a tight fit. It was really warm. So, I'm going to move the stuff inside now. Yeah, it's just about the length of me sat up with my legs outstretched before they're exposed in the open part there. And see if we can't get a brew going. This clip there within the whole footage might be a bit cloudy. And now I'm inside, my breath is condensating and it's filling the hole up with breath. I've just put some snow on to melt. There's my feet there, the exit there, entrance, bag, a bottle with some milk in, and a mug there for some tea. And the plan is now I'll just stay in here, boil up a pan of snow. It takes a lot of snow to melt down to a mug. In volume, and we'll get a brew. As I say, it's pretty compact, there's nothing special, but the difference in here, you can't even hear the wind outside. It's blowing again, it's really blowing out there, blowing the right gale. The snow's hammering down. And they forecast snow for the next few hours, so you can see it there, and just you can see the bits of snow crystallizing just with the heat off my body. Of course, if you were stuck out in the wild, something as simple as this will save your life. It's probably about freezing in here. There's outside, it's probably about -6, -7. Even see drips coming off the snow over there. The heat of the gas stove. And later on, I'll fire up my barbecue bucket. I'm going to build a cut into the wall over there. And then I'll put the barbecue bucket in there. And hopefully the smoke will go out and not fill up in here. And I'll peel some potatoes, fry them up, and have a couple of chip butties. Yeah, you wouldn't think that this was just on the side of a country lane. As I say, there's the wall. There's a hedge growing on the top of that bank. It's actually quite comfy, this. I'm feeling a bit cold on my back now because I'm leaning against the back of the tunnel. But a bit of good insulation. Keep it away from the actual cold, you know. Cheeks of my arse are getting a bit cold and all. And I'm sat on another coat as well. It's you could insulate yourself from the snow. This would be really, really comfortable. Yeah, I just wish the drift had been a bit bigger. Would have been a lot more interesting. I could have doubled the size of this chamber. Yeah. Spot on. You can see that. You can actually see the steam coming off my gloves where they got a bit damp. that heap pan of snow made a nice mug full of tea there. I'm just going to give it a stir now with a little spoon. Put another tea bag in actually. Oh. Chew in there now. I like strong tea. And turn the gas on. Oh. Chipping back a leveret. Bit of milk. And quiet. Well, the weather's really come in now. It's quite the blizzard. See the snow whipping up there. Zoom in on that. Nice and snowy. I've just had me brew and I've cut that shape out there. I'm going to put my barbecue bucket there in a bit and feel some spuds and get a little fire going. And have a couple of chip sandwiches, chip butties. Awesome. Just lit a little fire in my now well-known barbecue bucket, and got a block of lard in there. As soon as that's melted, I'll get my chips on. Flame that. I'm just waterproofing my hands, as it were, making them a bit warmer as well. I've got a thin pair of woolen gloves on, and I'm stretching a pair of rubber gloves over them, washing gloves, marigolds. And that'll just stop the gloves getting wet. I took my hat off before because it was hot walking through the snow. There's about another inch to 2 inches come down in the last couple of hours, and this drift has got a little bit bigger as well. And so it's got a bit hot walking about in the snow, and took my hat off. Now the snowflakes and melts on my head, and it's actually freezing on my head, top of my head. What bit of hair I've got is now going stiff. Nice little flame there. Put the chips in. Hear them starting to fry now. It's a bit smoky in there, just where the fire is. Uh, There doesn't seem to be any smoke going inside the hole, which is good. Oh, a bloody frog in my throat, just getting over the cold. One of those pain in the arse ones. Bit of a sore throat for a couple of days. Running nose and a cough. It's on the right side of it now, but throat's easily irritated, and that smoke's just starting me off again. Just zoom in a bit there. The fire is illuminating the entrance of the hole there. It looks quite good from quite a few yards away. There's glow coming out the snow. I'll zoom in a bit there. Yeah, nice. If you can see that, but nice place of chips there. Nibble on them now. Can't beat chips fried in lard. That wasn't too bad. Nice little fry up, chips. I love chips. So that's about that wrapped up. I'm just gonna take shelter in this hole for a little bit, and got a little transistor radio which I bring camping with me, and I'm just going to try that. I don't think I'll get much of a signal in there, and it's pretty bad with all the hills and the shadows and the valleys and the bumps in Wales to get any more than a couple of channels at the best of times, but I'll give that a try. And then I'll have a snooze for a couple of hours. Nice and warm in here. A bit breathless, it's bloody cold. It's no hint of wind, and it's lit up nice with that candle there. Not bad at all. I'm just going to try out my little radio. I always take a little transistor camping. You get stuck in your tent with bad rain or something. It's always.
Yeah,
I've got a signal anyway, despite 2 feet of snow. Not bad. So I've got a good signal. Back in his bag, keep it waterproof. Yeah, quite impressed with this snow hole. Needs to be a lot bigger, but I was constrained by the size of the drift. Otherwise, I'd be sat right up, or kneeling up, probably 6 feet across, 6 feet high. Would have been nice. It's all in all, very good project. Very pleased. And hopefully in time we'll get some decent snow again. Good snow, not just powdery rubbish. And do a really good project. The road's being ploughed now. So I'll just move out the way before I get ploughed. My snow hole probably won't last much longer. I think he has just made the road passable. And I'll just go back to what I was saying. But despite this ploughing, my snow hole's in place. But I wouldn't have liked to have been inside when that come along. The entrance now is nearly gone, as you can see there, as a load of ploughed snow has just gone up against it. So I'll set off, and that'll conclude this little adventure till the next bout of snow.